is multi-camera production? Generally, multi-camera production is nothing but you are using multiple cameras at a time to record an event. When you are using more than one camera, which means two or more cameras when you are using to record a film or to shoot something or to shoot an event, etc., that is called multi-camera production. Multi-camera production is nothing but where you are using different cameras and at the same time, if you see a single camera production, the post-production takes place at different point of time and the production takes place at a different point of time. But in a multi-camera production, generally, simultaneously the shooting is taking place and at the same time recording the event and it is also transmitted for the audience. So in a multi-camera production, generally we are using more than two cameras, or the number of cameras may be depending on your event. You may be using different cameras, the number of cameras may be different. So depending on your budget also, you may be planning your multi-camera production with a limited cameras, or maybe you are using more cameras. If you want to shoot like sports events, etc., cricket match or anything, you may be using more than 16 cameras, or depending on the, if it is a single camera production, it is an offline production, the simultaneously it will not be edited. But if it is a multi-camera production, the final output is nothing but it is a program which is ready to telecast. When you are using multiple cameras, more expensive when you compare with the single camera productions. So single camera productions can be handled by a single person. A camera person, if he is the one who is acting as the director or the producer, then a single person may shoot everything. But if it is a multi-camera production, a lot of persons who are required. It is a teamwork basically, and based on the director's directions, the program or event is. If you see multiple camera productions, plan the event well before the action takes. A lot of planning is required for the multi-camera production. If it is the ENG kind of thing, single camera production, etc., if you are going to cover an event, generally you may go there and you may capture the visuals and you may identify some sources, or you may be taking some bites from the audience or whoever may be there present on the location, etc. But if it is a multi-camera production, it is not possible. You cannot plan after the event has begun because it is going on live. There is no need of interrupting the program. So if you don't want to interrupt the program, which means a lot of coordination has to be there between the people who are there in producing the program. In a multi-camera production, what happens? Different camera persons are placed at different places with their cameras and the event is covered from the different angles. And if you see the production control room, the output of all these cameras is reaching the production control room and that is going to be filmed for the audience. It means simultaneously the camera persons are recording the visuals based on the directions and the output is reaching PCR production control room, and there are some vision mixer operators, audio mixer operators, technicians along with the director and producer. There are more number of persons who are handling this and they are monitoring the output and then they are going to transmit for the audience. What kind of equipment we are using? Generally, there we will be having first something where the action is taking place, that is studio floor, and second one is where the editing process is taking place, that is production room. Along with that, we may be having the makeup room, we may be having the studio office, we may also have a set or property room, we may also have the recording station where the voiceover or any other things are recorded. And it also includes the library where the final outputs or the program, whatever is transmitted for the audience, that is saved in a DVD form or CD form or any other form. Studio required all these facilities so that the multi-camera production can be taken place. If you see the studio floor, generally depending on the number of cameras you are using for the multi-camera production, you are taking into consideration. It may be a large studio or it may be a mini studio where the action is taking place or where the event is being planned. The studio floor may be divided into two parts. Generally, the first part, if you see, where the action is going to take place, and the second one is the other side of the studio where The multiple cameras or different cameras are placed from the different angles. And sometimes there are maybe cameras where the ceiling is there, then there also you may be placing some cameras. If you on the studio floor, there are various camera persons handling different cameras based on the directions of the producer or the director who is sitting in the control room or production control room. So if you see the studio floor, generally studio floor is very smooth so that the cameras can be physically moved from one place to another place. Generally cameras are fixed with the tripod so that the camera physically will not move and the so that the subject whom you are capturing will not looks like a moving person. The cameras for the movement generally they are fixed with the dollies. Dollies will have wheels so that the physically you can move the camera on the wheels so that it will not look like abrupt moving of the camera. The subject will not abruptly move from. Cameras are fixed on the tripods. Then the camera tripod is fixed with the dolly so that the camera physically can be moved. Studio floor, you also have lighting facilities. All those lights generally are fixed. If it is maybe a discussion between three members, etc., 3-point lighting, 4-point lighting, etc. So in a 3-point lighting, one light can be used as a key light. It is looking at one subject. The other light is used as a background light. The other one is fill light. So these three lights are placed at different places. So one subject may be opposite to the one subject, one light may be placed. The next light may be placed opposite to the one other person and one light may be placed so that the background will not have shadows. So that is 3-point lighting. So depending on the number of persons who are going to be there before the camera, based on that you may be having different lights. So if it is a multi-camera production, if you are using more than three cameras, etc., then the lighting is different. So you may be using different kinds of lights so that all the lighting, whatever is required for the production, is based on your lights. Audio instruments, if it is a multi-camera production, generally the microphones are hanged from the roof. Sometimes if it is a 3 or 4 members who are sitting, the wireless kind of mics can also be used. Wireless label mics also can be connected to the control room and sometimes wireless microphones is also can be used. So wired microphones or wireless microphones, boom mics or whatever may be the mic, those are used for the multi-camera production. So we have the talent before the cameras, we have lights, audio or microphones placed, cameras and camera persons. Along with that, for the smooth functioning of event on the floor, generally we also have a person called floor manager. The director who is sitting in the production room, who is giving directions or instructions to the floor manager, and based on that instructions, floor manager is here on the floor making the people ready for the shoot. So if the director asks whether the floor is ready, whether the cameras are ready, etc., then the he may just show the thumb in front of a camera, then the director will come to know the studio floor is ready for the shoot. Then he may say camera, tape rolling and action. Then the action may take place on the studio floor. Multi-camera setup, if you want to shoot, first you need to have a studio floor where the event is happening. The second one is production control room where the action or whatever may be the event on the studio floor, that is going to be recorded in the production control room where the director or the producer is sitting and monitoring all the production. So if you see the production control room, what are the things which are there in the production control room? Generally, in a production control room, we will be having studio monitors, then there will be a preview monitor, there will be an audio mixer, there will be a vision mixer, there will be a studio speakers, there is also a talkback system from the production control room to those if they want to speak with the persons who are there on the studio floor. So all the things are placed in the production control room. So if you see the studio monitors. Studio monitors are a kind of mini TV. If you have placed three cameras on the studio floor, the output of that three cameras is coming in the monitors. Those are called studio monitors. So which means the studio monitors are getting the footage which is being shot from different cameras on the studio floor. You may be having the vision mixer or video mixer, whatever. So that vision mixer is nothing but which is connected the output from the studio monitors. Studio monitors are displaying the visuals which are coming from the studio floor. Then these are connected with the vision mixer, and vision mixer is nothing but where you have a facility to choose different kinds of shots. So if it is a discussion between two individuals, generally, so one camera is looking at one person, the other camera is looking at one person, and if it is a three camera setup, one camera is capturing the wide angle of a particular event, then the director may instruct the vision mixer operator when he has to take which shot or what kind of camera he has to take into account, and that is going to be going for live for the audience. Then you will have audio mixer. So audio mixer is connected with all the audio cables which are coming from the studio floor, where you can choose the audio of one subject or the other subject. So here, from there, all this vision mixer output, whatever is seen in the preview monitors, and whatever the audio mixer output is, whatever may be it, that is going to be recorded on the VTR or VTR, video tape recorder, etc. Then that is going to reach the final audience. In production control room, generally headphones also will be there, which can be used by the director, so that he director and also audio mixer operator, so that they will come to know whether the audio is clear or not. Then there is also a graphic generator within the production control room. So multi-camera production, if it is live, generally the titles and other graphics are added to the original footage, and that is being recorded in the VTR along with the original video and audio, whatever we want to send for the audience. Then we have talkback system. As I said earlier, talkback system helps the director to communicate with the persons who are there on the floor. Generally, all those persons, like camera persons, the host, and others also having their earphones, they will be getting instructions from the director. If it is a camera person, the director may ask one camera person, like camera one, zoom in, camera two, zoom out, or camera one, tilt up, tilt down, whatever may be it. Along with the studio floor, we may also have, if it is a multi-camera kind of studio, then we also have a recording room. Generally, if it is a news production, generally if anchor is reading the news, and then if it has to be transmitted for the audience directly live, sometimes the voiceover is also recorded on live. Then we also have video library, where whatever the program is transmitted using the multi-camera output videos, the final program, whatever is transmitted for the audience, that is kept for future use as a file. Along with that, all that log tapes which they use, so all that are kept it in the video library, so that they, if they want again to maybe show the program, etc., the final footage, whatever has transmitted for the audience, that also can be again transmitted for the audience. It can be in the form of DVD or CD or whatever may be the final output, that is being kept in the video library. Then we also have edit suits. Generally, if it is an online production or offline production, like single camera production, we have edit suits. Edit suits will have the software to edit the audio and also the video. Sometimes if it is a multi-camera productions, each segment, it is not a continuous process. Sometimes the segments also can be recorded, and it can be edited, and it can be transmitted for the audience. And sometimes, even though it is a multi-camera production, if it is live, simultaneously the editing also takes place. Then we also have a set and property store. There are some sets which are designed for that particular program, and sometimes, even though it is not a set completely. You can change the background. You must be knowing the keying facility which is there in Edit Suits. Keying is nothing but if an event or a show or an interview, whatever it may be, if it is recorded using a background in blue color or maybe a green color, the background of the visuals can be changed. But you have to use proper lighting so that the keying will not disturb the original visual footage, whatever we have recorded. So these are the all those facilities which will be there in the studio and of a multi-camera production. The shape of a studio, any studio, if you take into account, generally all those studio, it is in a rectangular shape. So depending on the kind of program you are planning for the multi-camera production, the studio, the length and width of it varies from one studio to another studio. The size also changes. Then the ceiling height, generally, if it is a multi-camera production, the ceiling may have more height. Then studio floor, as I said, studio floor must be very smooth so that the camera's physical movement may take place with the help of the dollies. One of the most important aspect of the studio floor is acoustic treatment. So in a studio, generally, acoustic treatment is done. The doors, whatever the doors we are using, that also will not allow the noises which are coming from the outside. And the studio walls also, acoustic treatment is done so that it will not regenerate any audio, which means when the persons, the talent are speaking, the resound will not get. And we also use noiseless air conditioners. Because there is no ventilation facility within the studio and there are no windows, etc. Because of that, we use air conditioners to cool down the studio. And because you are using lights, the lights generate more heat. Because of that also, you are using the air conditioners so that the studio floor is cool. Production control room is there adjacent to the studio floor generally. Because the cables and other wires are to be connected to the control room, then all those sets and properties, whatever we are using for the multi-camera production, that are preserved in the set and property room. Video library, I said that final programs are preserved in the video library. Equipment. The equipments we use for the production. Vision mixer enables the director to choose different visuals which are coming from the studio floor. Studio cameras. The studio cameras are high quality or HD cameras which are used to record the video. Then VTR has become a replacement of VTR with the memory cards. So with the technology available, we are maybe using the memory cards to record the final output. And chroma keying technology, it is there in the vision mixer. Nowadays, whatever vision mixer we are using, keying part is also is part of the vision mixer. So we can change the background of the event. If you want to physically move the camera on the studio floor, we may use dollies or tracks or whatever. But if it is a multi-camera outdoor production, the cranes and other things also can be used to shoot. We are using the teleprompter. Teleprompter will reflect whatever the reader or the anchor has to read. So the teleprompter, it displays the things which the reader or the TV anchor has to read. The graphic designing software is also there within the production control room, where the graphics and titles also generated if it is a program on live. Studio monitors are already, I said, which source kind of monitors which gets footage from the studio floor to the control room. And a preview monitor is there. Preview monitor is nothing but which shows the visuals which are chosen for the broadcast by the director. So then preview monitor will displays the visual which is being selected by the director or the producer for the audience. Then along with that, sometimes if it is live, generally additional monitors also will be there, which will be containing the commercials which has to be used are transmitted by the particular channel if it is a live. So the commercials, in between the commercials, if it is live, generally the commercials are also added, and that is also transmitted for the audience. Audio equipment, if you see, generally microphones, as I said, omnidirectional microphones, bidirectional microphones, or unidirectional microphones. So whatever may be the microphone catches the sound from the location and it is being recorded. The process of multi-camera production, we have discussed about what is multi-camera production, where we are using. So multi-camera productions are generally used for transmitting the programs in live, like game shows, quiz, sports. If it is a news channel, the discussions, all those are multi-camera productions. Generally, a multi-camera production is well-planned if you compare with the single-camera productions like ENG, EFP. In a multi-camera production, you are using two or more cameras. It depends on the kind of program you are producing. You may be using different kinds of cameras. The number of cameras may be varies. In the first thing, if it is a multi-camera kind of online production, first thing is script reading session. So the process, if you see the script reading session, generally most of the productions are script based, even though if it is an online production, there is a script. And some productions are semi-scripted, and only the interviews or talk kind of thing, it is not much scripted, but it is a semi-scripted. So here, so script reading session will help all the persons who are involved in the multi-camera production to get an idea of what is going to happen or what is going to shoot or what has to be done and what is going to be transmitted for the audience. So to get fair idea of this, a script reading session is conducted by the director. Then after that, dry run. Dry run is nothing but the director is the one who calls for dry run, which means where without the equipment is placed on the studio floor, the action part is taken place, which means the talent who are going to be there on the screen, etc., all that action part is takes place, so that the director will get an idea where the cameras has to be placed so that we get the right kind of footage for the audience. After the dry run, the crew persons, whoever is who are behind the camera, technically who are recording the visuals and audio, etc. So all those persons will get an idea of what is going to happen and where they can plan their cameras. So here the production crew gets an idea, along with that the director gets an idea what kind of shots he has to use for the final production, and he can compose the shots without placing the actual equipment for the recording. The talent or the persons who are going to be there on the screen will move, the action takes place before it is going to shoot. That is called dry. Then walkthrough. After the dry run session, generally a walkthrough session also will takes place. Then the camera persons or whoever are there on the studio floor, they will get an idea and they will place some of the equipment and action takes. So depending on the talent, they will fix the cameras. Then camera rehearsals, if it is not live, if you are going to record a multi-camera production and transmit later, if it is a kind of offline, then an event may be recorded in segments. So each time, camera rehearsals means each time when you want to shoot something, if you want to take a sequence or a segment of an event, generally for the purpose of that, a rehearsal is taken place, and before the actual shoot, whatever, it has been recorded and it has been seen later. If there are any modifications, the director will ask the talent and also the camera persons, etc., to what kind of visuals they have to capture or what the talent has to do on the screen. So based on that, the final production takes place, the final recording happens. So that is camera rehearsals. Before the camera, before the actual shooting, or camera rehearsals take place. if it is an entire event, or it can be taken place, or it may be parts of the segment. So after each segment, you may record and you will see how the output is going to come and the actual recording takes place. If it is a whole event, if they want to do also, it can be done. Then after that, the final recording takes place. So final recording is based on the directions. What happens? On the studio floor, the camera persons are ready with their equipment. They record the shots based on the directions of the producer. The camera persons are composing the shots. Shot composition means nothing but what are the elements which are going to be there. Things we have to eliminate in a particular shot. What are the things to be included? And the final recording takes place. If it is an online program, if you, I have already said, the studio monitors will get output from the studio floor. The preview monitors will show what kind of shot the director has chosen for the final audience. Along with that, the audio mixer getting output, the audio from the studio floor, the original audio that is going to be there with the, that is going to be recorded in the VDR or videotape recorder along with the right visual which has chosen by the director. Then along with that, it is also the titles and graphics also added if it is a live program, and all the things are transmitted for the audience. So that is multi-camera production.